Good morning class. In our last class we have done tenses. So in this class I am going to teach you subject verb agreement. So without any delay let us start with subject verb agreement. Must agree with its subject in number and person. That is, the verb should be of the same number and person as the subject. Here we have to follow some certain rules for this. Two or more singular subjects joined by and take a plural verb, such as Mohan and Sohan have passed. Here Mohan and Sohan are two different persons. So we have used the plural verb have. Note, sometimes two subjects are regarded as representing one idea and then the verb is singular, such as slow and steady wins the race. Here slow and steady refers to the same idea. That's why it is in singular number. Next, if two singular nouns refer to the same person or thing, the verb must be singular. The poet and philosopher is dead. Here, poet and philosopher refer to the same person. If two singular nouns joined by and are preceded by each or every, the verb is singular, such as each day and each hour brings us a fresh anxiety. Here day and hour are preceded by each, so the verb is singular. Next, two or more singular subjects connected by or, nor, either or, neither nor take a singular verb. Either Mohan or Sohan is in the wrong. Here we are talking either Mohan or of Sohan, so the verb is singular. Note, when one of the nouns or pronouns joined by or nor is in singular and the other in plural, the verb should be plural and the plural subject should be placed near the verb, such as John or his brothers are to blame. Next, if two subjects joined by or nor are of different persons, the verb agrees in person with the subject nearest to it, as either you or he is telling a lie. If two nouns are joined by, with or as well as, the verb agrees with the first noun. That is, if the first noun is singular, the verb must be singular, even if the second noun is plural. As, the king with all his ministers was killed. Though we can see ministers are plural, but it has agreed with the first subject, the king. So the verb is singular, was. Next, a collective noun takes a singular or plural verb according to the sense. If the idea of oneness is expressed, the verb must be singular. If the individuals of the collection are thought of, the verb must be plural. The jury were divided in their opinions. Here we are talking about the men of the jury. So, it is expressed in plural. When we are talking about the jury has elected its president, here jury refers to one body. So, it is singular in number. Next, either, neither, each, every, one must be followed by a verb in the singular, as each of the boys has done his best. Here we are talking about every boy, that's why the verb is singular. Next, errors due to proximity. Often the verb is made to agree in number with a noun near it instead of its proper subject. The cost of all these articles has risen. So here we can see that it is, though the articles are plural, we are talking about the cost. So we have expressed it in singular number. Plural noun denotes a specific quantity or amount. Considered as a whole, the verb is generally singular, as The Arabian Nights is an interesting book. Though we can see that before the verb nights, the word plural is placed, but we will express it in the singular number because we are referring to the single book, that is Arabian Nights. Next point is, a relative pronoun always agrees in number and person with its antecedent, as he is one of those men who know everything. So here we can find that though the men is referred over here as plural, that's why we are using the plural verb. So it will be no plural form, it will take the plural form. Thank you students, let us soon meet for the next class. I'm sure I shall be with some more lessons. Till then, stay safe, stay home.